When a new product, like Excel 2013, is first released, it often has many bugs, as do all computer programs of any size. Microsoft is very proactive at fixing bugs that are found, and regularly releases updates. Updates normally only fix bugs found in the original program, but Microsoft sometimes take things a little further by introducing new, or at least enhanced, features with their updates. I had many emails from readers of my earlier Excel 2010 books suggesting that some Excel features were missing or that some of the examples didn't work. In almost every case, the reader had switched automatic updates off and was using an out-of-date Excel version. So for that reason, it's really important to make sure that your Excel version is up to date. Normally, Microsoft Office, including Excel, will look after updates without you having to do anything at all. By default, automatic updates are enabled. This means that updates are downloaded from the internet and installed automatically. It's possible that automatic updates have been switched off on your computer, and in this case, there's a danger that you might have an old, buggy, out-of-date version of Excel installed. This lesson will show you how to make sure that you're using the latest, most complete, and most reliable version of Excel 2013. So to begin, we need to start Excel. You may still have Excel open from the previous lesson. I'm on the Windows 8 desktop here, so I click the Start button, bottom left, and then click on the Excel 2013 tile that you added in the last lesson. Excel now opens, and I click the blank workbook template to open a new blank Excel workbook. To make sure that automatic updates are enabled, I'll begin by clicking the File button at the top left of the screen. This takes you to Backstage View. Backstage View allows you to complete an enormous range of common tasks from a single window. Now I'm going to click Account towards the bottom of the list in the left-hand bar. Your account details are now displayed on screen. Notice the Office Updates button displayed in the right-hand pane. If all is well and automatic updates are switched on, you'll see a button similar to this one. But if automatic updates have been switched off, you'll see a button similar to this. In this case, you will need to switch automatic updates on. To do that, click the Update Options button, and then click Enable Updates from the drop-down list. Depending on how Windows security is set up, you might then have to click Yes on the next dialog. Now that Office updates are switched on, we can return to the main Excel screen. To do that, click the Back button at the top left of the dialog. And let's now close down Excel by clicking the Close button. That's a little black cross at the top right of the Excel screen. And you've now completed Lesson 1-2. Check that your Excel version is up to date.